Well guys, what's up? Welcome back to my kitchen. Today we're going to be making some traditional Scotch pancakes from this little cookbook. Yeah, do you remember it? It's a cookbook from the 1970s. So yeah, this book's got loads of weird recipes in it. Although the pancakes are actually pretty modern. Just say that. So, for example, let's see if I can get a really weird... Yeah. For example, Kingdom of Fife pie. First ingredient, one young rabbit. Yeah, I know, that's weird. Strange, I know. I would not want to eat that. Let's just say that. But today we're going to be making Scotch pancakes. Also, this book's all in imperial measurements. So what I've done is I've rewritten the recipe in metric quantities so that you don't have to do any conversion. So, yeah. Yay. Another thing to note, this might be my last video in this kitchen. It may not be, I don't know. I might do a Christmas special later on down the line, probably will. But anyway, it'll be one of the last videos filmed in this kitchen, because I am moving house. During the move, expect uploads to be less, well, frequent. They're not already not frequent, but you know, expect to have less than maybe one month or something, while we just settle into the new house. So anyway, let's roll the intro and get into the cooking. Right, so guys, the first thing we are going to do is we're going to combine all of our dry ingredients. So we're going to start off with the 231 grams of self-raising flour. Then our 75 grams of sugar. That's caster sugar, by the way. And then teaspoon of baking powder. And we'll just... Next, what we want to do is we're going to add in our two eggs. So what we're going to do, crack an egg, you've seen this before. I actually recommend cracking on the table as opposed to the side of the bowl, because you get a much cleaner crack. So anyway, I'll just leave these at this side for now. Yes, by the way, these will go in the bin once I find them. Let's give a good crack on the work surface and then just go like. Okay, mix it. So I'm going to come back when this is all mixed. So your batter mixture should look something like this before you add the milk. Now, once we've given another wee quick beat, it's meant to stick to the whisk, that's perfectly normal. Yep. So I'm just going to add in the milk gradually until it forms a batter-like consistency. Now, obviously you can use an electric mixer for this, but I wouldn't recommend it. If anything, just gets your hand muscles working, you know what I mean? Yeah, you need to gradually add it in, so... Can you guys see them? You can. So you start to form a wee bit of a batter now. You want to beat the lumps out of it. It will take forever. And it will give you an arm workout. And also it looks a wee bit thick, so dash more milk. It still looks like a cake batter. It's not what cake looks like. So what we're gonna do is just go for a wee bit. Down the whisk. That's probably plenty. So plenty of batter. That's probably that to get into any batter system. And by the way, if you want to recover your batter after you've added a wee bit too much flour, what you need to do is just add in more flour. So if you add too much milk, just add a wee bit more flour. Can't bother at all. Okay, we've got bang, get all this stuff up. Right, so basically we're going to be dry frying these pancakes, so Basically, all dry fried means is you get a non-stick pan, and then you don't put any oil in it. So wait till it gets somewhat hot enough. Pour a bit in. Now, because these will rise up considerably, you don't want a lot of batter in the pan at a time. Just sort of like farming it about a little bit just to get a wee bit of, distance. First one's always your testing pancake. Now, the reason why these are so thin in the pan, as you can clearly see, is these will rise up quite a bit because of the self-raising flour and baking powder we've added into them. So, wait till the bubbles have all popped. Noise. Or just the bubbles all popping. Listen to it. So we're just waiting for all the bubbles to pop. Finally, flip the pancake. Oh, look at that, like a dream. There you go. Oh yes! That's gonna be really nice! It's probably one of the best ones I've ever done. Blame the camera. So anyway, it should look something like that once you flip it. And then see, because we're dry frying, you get a really nice thing without all the unevenness you get from using oil. So it's like so much better than just making regular marinade pancakes, which are full of grease. Let's just say that. It's a traditional Scotch pancake. These are actually quite thin. Oh, perfect. So the finished product, if you look a little bit of this. Thanks for watching this video. Please like and of course subscribe for more videos like this one. So now if you excuse me, I'm just going to eat these pancakes.